Hello, I'm Petrea King, and I want to share with you just a little bit about what we'll be addressing at the wonderful conference in 2011. There are many events in life that just stop us in our tracks, and they cause us to really consider the deeper questions of our own existence, of who am I? What am I doing on the planet? Am I living the life I came here to live? If not, why not? And what am I going to do about it? And sometimes we take on in our very early life some patterns that continue to inform and dictate how we engage with the challenges that we have, and that these patterns really no longer serve us. But they've become second nature to us. And you'll often hear people say, oh, it's second nature for me to think like this. It's second nature for me to feel this way. It's second nature for me to react like this. And no one ever questions, well, what is your first nature? And it's sometimes not until we bump into what I call the D's in life. We bump into a disappointment, a drama, a disaster, a diagnosis, a death, a debt, a depression, a depletion, a disillusionment, a disability, a disfigurement, a drought, a debt. There are lots of these D's, and when we bump into one of these D's, everything that's second nature to us simply doesn't work. It might be second nature to us to isolate ourselves, to withdraw from life. It might be second nature to us to drown our sorrows or to numb ourselves with drugs or busyness or any number of activities. It might be second nature to us to jump into one of the patterns of I do it myself. It might be second nature to us to fill up our life with so much busyness that we don't even have time to feel. But this D, whatever the D is, demands more of us than we might ever have had to draw on up until now. And we begin that wonderful journey back home to our own essential nature. And it's usually not until we get to the place in our life where we say, that's it, something has to change, and it's me. I can't change the outer circumstance of my life. I can't change the D, whatever it might be. It's happened. What I can change is who I'm going to be in relationship to that. And once we get to that place where we say, I'm over it, something has to change, and it's me, it does. You'll find that the whole universe will conspire to bring peace about if that is your absolute desire and intent. So once we want peace more than anything, more than being right, more than doing it the way we've always done it, more than hanging on to resentment, hanging on to blame, hanging on to, I have to have a cure in order for me to feel at peace. So a willingness to have peace more than a cure, resentment, blame, being right, hanging on to righteous indignation. Once we want peace more than anything, the whole universe conspires to bring it about, and we begin to find the stepping stones that lead us back home to our essential nature. You might find, if you've been in that place, that suddenly a book came your way, or a workshop or a conference like this one, or a person came into your life, or you turned on the radio and it was just what you needed to hear. So this is part of our consciousness and part of the grand design of our humanity and our spirituality to make this return journey back home to what is truly essential in our nature, not as what has become second nature to us. So in this talk, I'll be exploring that, and then I'll also be exploring the key elements that lead to a profound sense of peace within yourself. Very, very practical. Indeed, it's just common sense. It's just that common sense now, of course, is very rare. So this will be a talk that you'll be able to apply in your daily life from the moment that you hear it, and you'll feel inspired and encouraged because it's very practical and very easy to implement. I look forward to joining you at the conference.